Hello friends, welcome to your very own channel sonisinghphysics. In this video I am going to discuss about electricity and magnetism. This is second part of this topic. In first part I have discussed about electromagnetic induction. The whole concept we are going to learn with the help of questions, and this is the first question in front of you. Figure shows a horizontal conducting wire XY between two opposite magnetic poles. Wire XY forms a circuit with an ammeter, and question is, explain why the reading on the ammeter is zero when the wire XY is not moving. So what is a common mistake done by student? Since there is no current, that's why no deflection in ammeter. So this is a very common answer written by students. What we should do? Student should answer why there is zero current, and the correct answer is zero current because there is no cutting of magnetic flux or magnetic field lines. Next is, the wire XY is moved and there is a deflection on the ammeter that indicates there is a current in the wire from X to Y. On table 7.1, tick one box to indicate the direction of the movement of the wire XY and explain your answer. So here you have to use Fleming's left hand rule to find answer of this question. In my previous video I have explained in very much detail how to use Fleming's left hand rule, and as per the rule the correct answer will be to the bottom of the page. Now we'll see what are the common mistakes made by the student. Student often do mistake by writing Fleming's left hand rule as part of explanation. So examiner's comment is, do not write names of any rule as part of explanation, then write rules or law itself. So here also in this question you need to explain that why you have chosen answer as to the bottom of the page, and the explanation is current, motion and field lines are mutually at right angle. So this is actually Fleming's left hand rule, but we should not write the name of the rule, we should write what is it. Then next is, magnetic field lines from left to right. Since it is 3-mark question, so we have to write 3 points, and these are the 3 points. Then C is, state what is observed on the ammeter when the wire XY is moved. So the answer will be opposite current, opposite deflection. So when we move the direction of current in XY, then deflection will also opposite in the ammeter. Then in the same direction as part B but at a greater speed, then what will happen? Greater current and there will be a greater deflection. Let us see next question. Figure 8.3 shows a simple DC electric motor with a split ring commutator. So you can see these are different parts of DC motor: split ring, brush and coil. State and explain the direction of rotation of the coil as seen from point X. So before moving to the answer of this question, we will discuss the function of split ring and carbon brush. Function of split ring commutator R. The purpose of the split ring commutator is to reverse the current every 180 degree. This ensures that torque continues in the same direction. Torque means couple of forces which works opposite to each other. The split ring commutator makes connection with the rotor coil or armature. Torque is a measure of how much a force acting on an object causes that object to rotate. So this is the meaning of torque. And as you can see in this picture also. Next is carbon brushes. The primary function of carbon brushes is to deliver or collect current from a rotating part of an electric machine. The brushes maintains a close contact with rotating part or commutator or slip ring. Commutator is in the DC motor and slip ring in the AC. This is a question again in front of us and we have to answer. State and explain the direction of rotation of the coil as seen from point X. So we will use again Fleming's left hand rule to find the direction of rotation of the coil, and the statement will be the coil will move clockwise. We can also accept rotation arrow on the diagram, so you can mark arrow also. Then explanation is, force on left wire will be upward, then up arrow you can mark on that left side, then force on right wire will be down, then you can mark down arrow on the right side of the coil. So this is the explanation. This is the next part of the question. The coil rotates through 90 degree from the position shown. State what happens to the moment in this position. So observe this picture to understand movement of coil and what will happen when the coil will be at 90 degree. There will be no moment or zero moment. Then the next question is, the coil is rotated through 180 degree from the position shown. By considering the forces on the coil, explain how the split ring commutator enables the motor to turn continuously. So here we have to use our previous information about the function of split ring commutator, and the answer is, split ring commutator will reverse the current in the coil or changes direction forces. So still what will happen, left hand side will have upward force and right hand side will have downward force. So in that there will be a continuous movement will be maintained. So that's the function of split ring commutator. It reverses the direction of current in the coil and maintains the movement of the coil. This is the next question. The diagram shows a coil of wire between poles of a magnet. You can see picture. The coil consists of 20 turns of insulated wire. The coil is connected to a variable resistor and a power supply. The question is, how can the turning effect on the coil be increased? So here we have to choose the option by which we can increase the turning effect. And looking at all the four options, A will be the correct option, by moving the poles of the magnet closer to the coil. The rest three options are for decreasing the strength of the motor. This is our next question. The diagram shows a DC motor, as you can see in picture. Which two changes together will always make the coil spin more slowly? So here we have to use another way, that we have to reduce the speed of the coil. And for that, if you look at all the four options, the correct answer will be A. Decrease the current in the coil and use a magnet of less strength. So when we do this one, then definitely speed of the coil will reduce. So now we are going to see, what are the ways to increase the strength of motor, and when we use it in opposite way, definitely the strength will decrease. And they are increasing the size of the current, using a stronger magnet, increasing the number of turns of wire in the coil, reducing friction between coil and the axle it rotates on, then decreasing distance between poles of magnets. So these are the ways how we can increase the strength of a motor. This is the next question in front of us. The diagram shows an AC generator used to power a lamp. The coil rotates in a clockwise direction. So as you can see in this picture, the question is, which magnetic poles are X and Y? In AC generator, we use Fleming's right hand rule to find directions. And this is the Fleming's right hand rule. Thumb shows the motion of the conductor, that is upward. First finger shows the direction of magnetic field, that is towards left. And middle finger shows the direction of induced current, that is towards us or towards you. So that is Fleming right hand rule. So as per this rule, we will know the answer of this question. The correct answer will be answer B. And the explanation is, as you can see in the diagram, rotation of coil is clockwise. For that, force on the left arm should be upward and right arm should be downward. And magnetic field direction should be from X to Y. So that you can see in this picture also. So the correct answer will be B. This is our next question. Which graph shows the voltage output of an AC generator with the peaks and zeros correctly labeled? So we'll see that voltage generation in AC generator, and this is a picture which will tell us that where it is peak and where it is zero. So as you can see, when the coil is at 90 degree and 270 degree, that is called peak, and there the voltage generation is maximum, and when the coil is at 0 degree, at 180 degree and at 360 degree, there the voltage generation is 0. So peak is at 90 degree and at 270 degree, and 0 is at 0 degree, 180 degree and 360 degree. So the correct answer will be answer D. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, you can text me, message me, or you can comment in this video. Please do like, subscribe and share your very own channel, Sony Singh Physics.